We're here at Miami Convention Center at the Dub Car Show.
What up, baby?
What's going on, man?
And,
no, we're good. I just had a Mountain Dew on the way in. I'm all right.
Come on, man. You're
ready to fight. Hey, let me get a picture with you, dude.
All right, on.
I got my side.
Yeah, we're gonna go.
One second.
Hug me out, bro.
I got him.
Nice,
brother.
Man, take care.
Same, man.
Hey, good luck,
Tom. So we're here at the Miami Convention Center at the Dub Car Show doing a signing. I got Leah and One Punch and Zohan with me. So take care of business.
Who else are we going to see here?
I don't know. We're going to see T-Bow and Richie. I know that much. That'll be exciting.
Nice.
I said red Skittles. Only red Skittles I asked for.
Pushing in on my signing time.
Come over.
Hey, what's up? It's Labor Day weekend. We're at Pitbull's house for a barbecue and a party with DJ Sula spinning on the 1 and 2s. It's Pitbull's girlfriend Amber's birthday. You can fit that all into one coherent sentence. Right now we got Haider Hassan.
Gotta eat your meat, get your protein.
He's not only a fighter, but he's a chef.
Yeah, he's also a chef. He doubles as a chef and a fighter and a couple other things. Right. Makes some really good baked goods, cookies and brownies.
Well, we're doing a little barbecue, you know, to celebrate Labor Weekend. Right, Labor Weekend?
Yeah.
And, you know, I got all my teammates in here, you know, it's my girl's birthday, so we're doing what we do, you know, ATC, we're having fun. Even when we're not training outside of the gym, we're together. We got Richie Antonino right here.
Yeah.
You know, we got Haider Hassan. We got
yeah.
A couple of studs, you know, we know how we do.
And this is to be the last time you get to eat like this, and then your camp starts.
Yeah, after this, don't you get to you next week, so I got 9 weeks for my next battle, so this is the last time. So if you guys see me, you know, getting a little bit crazy, don't judge me. That's all I say. Don't judge me.
Yeah, don't worry. We got plenty of sausage right here.
Yeah.
We got plenty of sausage. Ladies, don't worry.
Tinky, this is my son. Tinky boy. He loves barbecue thing.
Good boy. How good are
you? Hey, what do you call this?
Sopica.
Told you.
Do that?
Teaching Primo Portuguese words. He's half Brazilian. Imagine that.
You're not going to have any rice and beans?
You got to save room for steak.
Get the rice. Lift that up. What is that in Portuguese?
Feijão.
What are these things?
Those are chicken McNuggets. They look like McNuggets.
What are you putting on?
Just kosher salt. Before you marinate with a little bit of soy sauce, and then once you put it in the grill, you know, you lay on it and just lay a little bit of kosher salt, you know, every time you flip it, and you just paste a little bit with, I can't believe it's not butter.
You know, Brazilian
sauce. That's how we do it, by the way, Brazilian sausage, too good.
Your next fight?
We're fighting November 5th in England, fight against Papia Badgie. Big scary dude, but I'm gonna knock him the fuck out. So, you know, what we're doing right now, we're in a eating phase. So I'm eating a lot so I can be very strong to kick his ass. That's exactly what we're doing.
Eu falo português pouquinho. Meu nome é Richard.
What else? I know a lot of bad words.
Puto que pariu, caralho, porra.
I don't know. I'm kind of pila puta. No, that's too basic.
Cara de cu?
No. I know the one. My mouth is gonna come to me.
Emprestado.
Pego emprestado.
Oh, tudo isso seu? Você pegou emprestado, eh?
They told me to speak Portuguese.
Okay.
Said tudo isso seu? Você pegou emprestado, eh?
That's putting that phrase into use. That's how you do that. That's the proper usage of it.
Portuguese 101?
Portuguese 101. How to chauvinistically approach a woman, yet impress her at the same time.
It wasn't like that.
I was flexing. I'm checking my bicep flex
out. You know, I wanted to see that, you know, beautiful.
Is that it?
No, yeah, no, that's it. This is
I've never seen you.
I know, but damn.
Welcome to Sparta!
Heaven, Brazilian food.
Dolce diet.
This is
a Brazilian Dolce diet.
This is not the Dolce diet, but it's really good though. It's rice with feijoada, with picanha, a little bit of vinaigrette. If you're Brazilian, you know what I'm talking about. And we got what? Brazilian sausage. Can't go wrong with that.
Look at it, the green one.
Really? Am I gonna regret this?
Yes. Yeah, you are.
Do you like that plate?
Woo, sorry. You're holding my camera up. No, I'm kidding.
What we were saying was, and then right, and when you're playing boo, because right, when you play the Englishman like me, one punch, and I'm winning, and I've been winning.
Exactly.
The
English speaking people versus the
Brazilians. Yeah, well, there's only actually one English speaking person here. I don't know what Brad's speaking. He's speaking Pikey or something. But no, it's the allies versus the Brazilians. We were challenged by the Brazilians.
If we win this, we're going to call the Mexican Border Patrol.
Oh! Oh! That was quick.
Patrick.
What's up?
Take two.
Not you.
You get like somebody like, just hold him down, hold him down.
There's a rule, right?
There's a rule that 1 foot always has to touch the floor, but it's Brad. He's got like 9-inch legs.
Do you want me going in force?
Well,
too
high. Well,
just go and graze it.
Okay, eight. Just think about power, getting the white ball at the top back.
Right, so we'll push it that way and right in and try and graze it into the pocket.
And you got way by stone.
Right, of course. Right, and then it's stones and you're getting hit it in the bones with right, for a pick
and
push.
It's like sticks and stones.
Right, break the bones, but names will hurt you too.
Yeah.
Right.
And what palm? Don't hit it that hard. Did you get? You smashed it as hard as you could.
I didn't know. Right, I took the cue, and then what happened was once I hit the thing, and then ran around, right? And right in the woods, and what happened was bollocks, lad. Bollocks. And I put it into the thing, bollocks, lad. Get the torch, look where it went on the green, and alright, and I hit it on the thing with the punk, with the ball, okay? Bollocks.
Bollocks.
Look, let's bring it together.
I don't know.
We gotta bring it together. Listen, it's 1-1. It's one, one.
Slap.
Come on.
1-1. We didn't win that one. The only reason we really ended up winning the first one was because of McAhone's terrible scratch. Catella is unbelievable, man. I don't know what else to say. Apparently, that guy has a pool table at home too.
Are you tired of carrying Brad?
Me, Pickett. It's been me all day, man. I've been making all the shots. You know, my fabulous breaks that I've had. You know, to start the game off. I mean, how much better could you set up the entire board than, you know, those two shots I hit in the beginning? I'm getting no support from Brad Pickett, but we're still a team, and we're, you know, gonna work together. Let's do this.
What did you just do?
Just put chocolate macarons head, you don't even notice.
You gotta be kidding me.
This could define you as a person. This could define you.
Don't put too much pressure on me.